Hey guys, and welcome to the first episode of Just Making Art. And in this first segment, it's just called The Mood, I think. Yes, it is. And with The Mood, what I do is I just draw a chibi of myself. I draw a chibi of myself, and I'm gonna have like a bunch of chibi cards of me. And just like the mood of the month. And the mood of the month, of course, this October, is Halloween. So it's kind of scary. So I have me holding a cute little adorable pumpkin, like a chibi me, and I'm just like, oh my god. Because this is normally me on Halloween. I'm just like spooked out, and I'm like, okay, just give me candy, and I'll leave. But, so, yes. And so, there's really not too much to say. It's just that I'm making the little chibi of me, and I kind of didn't let the ink dry, and when I was erasing it, I let it smudge because I wanted to give it that smeary type of effect. And I think it actually came out really good. And what I do now is I'm just adjusting the camera, and then I add in the shadowing, and yeah. So, yeah, next month will be November, which the theme will probably be something related to Thanksgiving or my birthday, or both. I may do two GBs. But, yeah, that's really it, and on to the next segment when you guys finish watching this. Hello guys, this is my themed art picture, and it is of a little vampire, and it is awesome and stuffs. So, I did it on a Strathmore toned tan sketchbook, and it is these sheets, and what size is it? I don't know what size. 5.5 inches by 8.5 inches, and yar, so, hold on, okay, audio quality is sucking right now, not really, because the audio sounds really good, but, so it's a little vampire, and he's out at night, and I'm just sketching in the moon. Oh, mind you, I only use a 12-pack of Prismacolor Scholar pencils and a Prismacolor, light peach premier colored pencil. So, I think it came out pretty good. This part only took me about, I'd say, 16 minutes. The next segment literally took me an hour, so I sped it up to like 12 times and 8 times, so it's like, oh my god, mind-boggling. But, other than that, I really don't have too much to say, except that I really like how this came out. He's got a little black cat next to him, and some pumpkins, and apples everywhere, and it's at night, and he's a little vampire, and he's like, oh my god. For next month, I may draw something, related to Thanksgiving, or my birthday, or I don't know. In the comments, you guys can tell me what you guys want me to draw for themed art for next month. But, other than that, I really don't have much to say. But when it comes to the third segment, I'm gonna be having music playing to keep you guys entertained. So I'm gonna say what about the third segment in this segment. So with the third segment, it's pretty much just fan art. So you guys can suggest to me down in the comments what you guys want fan art to be. In that segment, I can do a series of fan art, like a series of characters, which I'm going to be doing a series of characters. I think I'm going to do realistic vocaloids for a little while, and then I'm going to do other things. So, yes. So that's all I really have to say about that. Just suggest down in the comments what you guys want me to do for the fan art-wise stuff, and I will get on that. Other than that, this little thing's coming to a close. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys when we get to segment 4. So here is Miss Chocolate Fox, one of the competitors in this fourth segment. Say hello, Miss Chocolate Fox.
Hello.
Now, just introduce who you are, not your name or anything, no personal information, just what type of artist you are and just who you are. Go.
I'm Miss Chocolate Fox, and I don't really have a particular style, I guess, in art, but well, yet, I guess. But my cousin pretty much just taught me how, and yeah, I don't know what to say, dear.
Well, thank you, Miss Chocolate Fox, for that slightly interesting talking thing you've done. And now on to. So here's our second competitor of the fourth segment challenge, and it is.
Lesbian.
And she's just gonna talk about herself and her YouTube thing, career thing. I don't know what to call it. Okay, go.
So guys, as you may know, my name is Nyrell, and I would describe my art style as a mix in between of shoujo and shonen. I don't really think I have a specific style in either of the genres, so mine is just in the middle. So I guess I'm just a lucky one. So that's all I can say about my style. And it often changes quite often, but that's about it.
Thank you, Narelle. And now I've got to yammer on about me, but everyone knows. So, yeah. Thank you, Narelle. And this is my. So, let me just. I'm. Bleh. So, this is me, TheJMICreations. And my. I'm just a general artist on YouTube. And I may do the occasional video game walkthrough, but that's pretty much all I do is just pretty much art, and I do contests and stuff, and I'm here on the Daily Artists. And my style is a mix between manga slash anime style, cartoonish and realism, kind of all of those combined. And yeah, that's all I really have to say about that. So this is my kind of entry into our little contest. And the way this like we had and the way this contest works is some weeks we may have a theme, some weeks me and a couple other YouTube artists may have a theme we have to draw, or sometimes we may have to draw a oh no, squeaky voices. And some weeks we may have to do a challenge. But this week was a theme, and we had to create a bird, human character. And yeah, mine's based off of an eagle, and he looks kind of creepy and scary. But that was kind of the point because some people get spooked out by birds, and I kind of wanted to bring in the spooky aspect of it all. But the way this thing, way this type of, fourth segment goes, is what you do is in the comments. You all will vote on whose entry you liked best, and I'll announce it in next month's episode. But the people entering are me, Miss Chocolate Fox, and Narelle Busby. So we, the next video, the next part of after my entry will be Miss Chocolate Fox's, and then Narelle Busby's. But that's pretty much all I have to say about mine. It's just a eagle man, and he kind of looks creepy. But that's all I really have to say. The blending didn't go well because I kind of did it on computer paper, but for the way I did on computer paper, I think I like it. And please consider me for your votes. Thank you! So we're back with Miss Chocolate Fox, and this is her entry into the fourth segment challenge thing, blah-blah-blah-bobber, and here she is going to talk about it.
It's It actually is sort of like a phoenix, just like John said. Yeah. She's just, you know, sitting on a branch awkwardly with wings and a face and stuff. And she's sitting on a branch, and it was fun. Like to say, I like blending colors, it's fun. Like, random colors, like, I don't know. As you can see, her skin is gray because she's a bird. I mean, why would it be a regular skin color, you know? Yeah, I almost hit the microphone. Yeah, it was fun. It took me a long time.
How long? Sure.
I waited a couple days to color it. It took me probably the picture in general probably took like 2 hours to draw because I was doing something else, I think. But hey, let me be quiet. But I really like how the sock things came out because colors, I like colors. Okay. Yeah.
Thank you, Miss Chocolate Fox, for the wonderful thing of talkingness. And we are going to move on to our next competitor, and we will hear more from Miss Chocolate Fox at the end of this whole video. So here's Narelle back once again, and she is going to be talking about her entry into the mini challenge.
So you guys, at first when I started drawing this picture, I actually drew a guy eating a worm, and it was like a really small, like, ACL card type of picture. And throughout the week, I actually thought that I didn't really like it. So I actually wanted to start over with this picture. So what you're seeing now is a girl actually holding a big can of worms, and she's just happy to eat it like a bird would do. And her color scheme is going to be brown with red in it, because female cardinals are actually brown, and their fur, well, feathers, kind of fade into red. So that's how her hair is going to be like. So that's basically it for the girl. So for the background, I'm just going to add, like, trees to kind of give it, like, a birdie environment. So that's basically it for my drawing. It's not really too difficult to understand, just a female cardinal enjoying her dinner of worms.
Yep.
So, yeah.
And we will have at the end of each of mine, Narelle's, and Miss Chocolate Fox's, like, little segment parts, like, segments of the segment, we'll have, like, a finished picture of what the final product looks like. So, thank you, Narelle, and we will be seeing you one more time before this show ends.
Okay.
So pretty much on my channel, I haven't really posted that much on it yet, but I'm going to soon start trying to post more videos, but until then, I'm posting on The Daily Artists and on Thursdays, and how I met, I met Narelle first. I was sort of stalking her channel, and
just the greatest way to meet a person. I know. I'm stalking you.
And I added her on Facebook, and then we just started talking pretty much. And then I saw, and then I later, I think, subscribed to John's channel. And then, I saw the Daily Artist thing video up, like the collaboration video, and I was like, well, hey, I'm gonna join that. And yeah, that's pretty much how I met him. And then, maybe like a month later, I guess, we actually started talking on Skype, not too long ago, actually.
Yeah, we started talking last Monday.
Yeah.
I had the Labor Day live stream, or whatever last holiday was, Columbus Day, I don't know.
Well, I did always stalk him on his live stream.
Yeah, I noticed that. Every time you would, every time I had viewers come to the channel, it was either, it was always Winry Hikari, and then you were a normal comer to it. You were, it was always you and her, and then Narelle and Mimi would come a lot also.
Yeah.
For one, you know, one lucky stream, I had Fox of Nightmares, but I have him on Skype too, which is awesome.
I have Moneko on Skype.
I tried adding her, and then she hasn't responded yet. But people are haters, but not really. I'm just kidding. Moneko is awesome. But anything else you'd like to say before we move on to our next competitor, which everyone knows already is Narelle. So
I love chocolate.
Okay. Now, what does Fox say?
Chocolate
instead
of whatever it says.
Okay. Well, that's all the time we have for Miss Chocolate Fox, and now we're moving on to Narelle. So Narelle is back for her final little talking excerpt, and she is just going to explain, just like Miss Chocolate Fox did, about just like what her YouTube channel is about and how we met through you, how we came across each other on YouTube, and then how we met on like live stream or however that came about. So here you go, Narelle, take the spotlight.
Okay, so when I first started YouTube, I actually started doing songs and like putting lyrics to the songs, like lyric videos. And I figured out that my first two accounts actually got deleted because of that. So I was like, I kind of don't know what to use my YouTube for. So throughout the years, I actually thought of making my channel about my art because I see a lot of people doing it. And I was like, that seems fun. And I actually did not want to talk in videos because it's kind of awkward. But eventually, I got over it. And this is how I am now. So my channel is kind of weird because I don't really know what it's supposed to be about. It's supposed to be about my art, but I don't have a specific style I want my channel to be like. So I guess I'll have to figure that out throughout the rest of my life on YouTube. And how I came across TheJMICreations is I actually don't know. I don't remember exactly because my memory is just bad at this moment. But I believe he commented on my videos, and I think that's how we met, and I just checked out his art, and his art is amazing.
Thank
so
you.
Go check him out.
Yours is too, so go check her out also.
So that's how I believe we met, and I actually started talking to him on Skype because our friends, Miss Chocolate Fox and her friends, we actually talk on Skype most of the time, and that's actually how we actually started talking in person. Mm-hmm. So that's about it.
Thank you, Narelle. We hope to see you again in one of these segment challenges, which hopefully you'll be back before the end of this year, hopefully in the next, before, like, in a few shows, so hopefully you'll be back. And yeah.
I will.
Alright, and now on to my blabberness. Oh, wonderful. You guys get to hear me more. Yay!